Hello viewers, today I will teach you about the future perfect continuous tense, which is also called future perfect progressive tense. Definition: the future perfect continuous tense is used for actions which are started in present or past and will be in continuing over a period of time in the future. There will be a time reference such as since 2005, for 2 hours, from which the actions will be continue in the future. First of all, future perfect continuous tense is about the action which started in the past or started in the present and will continue in the future for over a time period. For example, there is a time period here which we use for particular time period since is written here 2005. Since means we are indicating about the exact time period or particular time period. Forward is used for the time which is showing you only the duration, time duration. So in this tense, the action started in the present or past and will be continue in the future and showing you a sense of time reference which is found, which gives an idea that action started at some time in present or past and will continue for some time in future. Such time reference or sense of time reference is the identity or showing you the past future perfect tense. Future perfect tense shows you the things that action started in the past or present and continue in the future and showing you the time period which might be the exact time period. So for the exact time period we are using since, and which might be the time duration where here we use the for. For example, for 2 hours, for 2 months, for 20 minutes and for 3 years etc. Rules for this tense. Helping verbs will have been or shall have been are used in sentence making plus first form of verb plus ing, or you can say also the present participle form of verb, which is ing form of verb, is used as a main verb in sentence, and since or for is used, as I've explained you about, for the time mentioning whether it is particular time period or the just time duration of time. So for is used before the time reference. These are used for the time before the time references in sentences. If the reference is made for particular or exact or accurate time period such as 2015, 6 o'clock, then we use the since word before the time reference in the sentence. And if the reference is made for duration of time period such as 2 hours, 9 years, 5 days, then we use for before the time reference. So rule number 2, here will or shall we have to use we have to use will or shall, both we can use, for but for the you, they, he, she, we have to use will here. This is a rule number 2. Example. Examples are here: in November he will be working at my company for 3 years. The first example is there and green words showing you that it's a future perfect continuous tense. In this tense you can easily understand that an action started, it might be he might be working for 2 years in this company, and might be in the November he will have been working for 3 years in the coming November. So this is showing you this sentence that the action started in a past and in the future the action will be going on and showing you the duration of 3 years. In the second example, at 5 o'clock he will have been waiting for 30 minutes. In the second example, you also can understand that the action in this case you can not say about the action started in the present or past, because we are not showing the time of right now. It means the action might be started right now, so it will be happen at 5 o'clock, that he will have been waiting for 30 minutes. If the time is right now is 4:30, so what happened in the future at the 5 o'clock, he will have been waiting for 30 minutes. And if the action started in the previous, for example, it's about the 4, it's right now the clock is showing you the time of 4:45. So what happened? The action started in the past, that 4:30 is the starting time of the action, and showing you the 30 minutes after at 5 o'clock, the action will having the 30 minutes. So this action might be started in the present or past. In the third example, when he turns 30, yeah, it means 30 years of age, he will have been playing piano for 3 years. In this case, you cannot say the action started in the present or past, whether you know the actual situation. But in the future, what happened? In the 30 years of age, he will be playing piano for 3 years. Structure of affirmative sentences or positive sentences. This is shown here in the chart. You can say subject plus will or shall plus have been plus ing form of verb, which is present participle form of verb, plus object. This is a simple way to write a structure. Now examples. Examples of affirmatives are there. By next December, they will be living here for 9 years. In this case, you can easily understand the action started in the past and going on for the future and showing you the duration of time of 9 years. In the second example, he will have been coaching for 3 years by next March. So what happened? By the next March, he will be coaching for 3 years. So this action is also started in the past and going in the future and showing you the duration of 3 years by next March or coming March, you can also say. Third example, he will have been searching new job for 2 years. This is also the same thing, that the action will be having a duration of 2 years in the future for searching a new job. And here we are writing future perfect continuous tense, which are shown in the green alphabets, the helping verbs and the verb form of ing. In the fourth example, he will have been living happily for a long time. This is also the same thing. The fifth one, during this period, he will have been searching many jobs. So these are the examples of writing the future perfect continuous tenses. Note, if there is no time reference or sense of time reference, then it is not future perfect continuous tense or progressive tense, because there is no hint about time of action, which when it will start in the future or end, it seems just on going on action in future, which resembles future continuous tense. It means that if the time reference is not mentioned here, for example, for a long time, for 2 years, by next month, so this will become a future continuous tense, not the future perfect continuous tense. And the second thing is that the future perfect continuous tense is not very common. It is not usually used in the common way of talking. So we used rarely this tense. Structure of negative sentences of this tense. Here just you have to write the not between the helping verbs. This is shown here. Subject plus will or shall plus not plus have been plus ing form of verb plus object, which is also called the present participle form verb here. Negative example of these tenses. In next December, they will have not been living. They will not have been living here. So in this example, you can easily understand, you have to place not between will and have. Not You will have to place not between will and have. So the sentence become, by next December, they will not have been living here for 9 years. In the second negative example there, he will not have been coaching for 3 years by next March. In the third example, you can also understand the third example, just place the not between will and have. He will not have been searching new job for 2 years. He will not have been living happily for a long time. During this period, he will not have been searching any job. For the interrogative sentences. In the interrogative sentences or question-making sentences, you just have to place the will or shall in the first position of the sentence. And the second important thing is that you have to mention the question mark at the end of the sentence. Here it is shown here. So the sentence become, for the questions here, number one is, will they have been living here for 9 years by next December? Question mark. Second example, will he have been coaching for 3 years by next March? Will he have been searching new job for 2 years? He will have been living happily for a long time. Will he have been searching many jobs during this period? Question mark. So these are the examples of the questions making sentences of future perfect continuous tenses. And the important point of these are this tense is, number one, action will be continuing in the future and having the, and second thing is that they're continuing for some time in the future. And the third thing which you know, you have to understand, the action started might be in the present, might be in the past, and will be continuing in the future and showing you the sometime period in the future. So this becomes the future perfect continuous tense. And this is normally very rarely used in the conversation. So today's my lecture is complete.